Assalamu alaikum. Well, here we'll see how to use Postman to send Firebase notification. Okay, now in general you'd be using Postman for debugging. A lot of time Postman is very useful for debugging, which is not possible directly from the simulator or emulator, which could be also annoying. So Postman makes it easy. So once you get the idea that it works on Postman, then it should also work on your real device or emulator or simulator. Okay, so that's what we'll see. Now, of course, to send message from Postman to Firebase or send post notification, you have to set up your Firebase correctly. Okay. Well, now in this tutorial, I'm not going to cover how to set up the Firebase correctly. I have other tutorial. You can take a look at them. No problem. Okay. So assuming that you have set up your Firebase tutorial correctly, then you need to get two kind of IDs to do that. Okay. Or two kind of keys, actually. One is called a server key. And there is called device token. Things like that. Okay, now so how to get the server key? All right, so I believe that you have set up your Firebase and you created two projects like Android and iOS, and after that you have to select your project. So in this case, this is the project that I've been working on, and here I have two projects like iOS and Android, as you can see over here. Now, it doesn't matter whatever it is, so you can click any of them, and then you would click on this icon, the one we did just now, and then it'll take you to a page like this. Okay, so once again, if you are confused, so you can select any of them, it doesn't matter, and then click on this icon. Okay, all right, and then you'd be clicking here, cloud messaging. Okay. Now over here, you'll see there is token for server key. So this is a token that we need, and this is pretty easy. You just go ahead and set up your Firebase project and you get this one. So this is the first thing we need, okay? All right, and we need another token. Well, this is a token, right? Now that token would be coming from your device, okay? Well, you have to set up your Firebase definitely, so here, which I did. So basically these two, others you can ignore. So Firebase core and Firebase messaging. All right. Okay, well, so these two. Now once you do that, at the top you have to initialize Firebase, and before that make sure you call ensure initialized. All right, after that nothing fancy. And I have a stateful widget, and in the stateful widget I have created a method which is called save device token. Now here you see this one. So I'm trying to get token for my device from Firebase. Okay, so here I'm just calling Firebase messaging dot instance dot get token. Okay, now if we can't get it, we print this one. If we can get the token, which means the token is not null, then we'll print the token over here, okay? So this would be printed. Now, once again, before you come here, you definitely have to set up your Firebase. Hopefully you did that. Now we'll run it. And once we run it, we might have some warning. So this is a warning, we can ignore that. Now here I see that a message where it says that device token, and exactly the message is coming from here, okay? So it's printing out over here device token, which we get using this line. Now of course getting device token is pretty easy actually, so just with this line we get the device token. All right, so what's the use of this one? Well, I'm going to tell you, but now by this time you know that we have two token. One is device token and another is token from the Firebase. So these are the two token we need to use as we work on our Postman. From Postman, we want to send push notification to Firebase, and then we want to get a response back from Firebase. And if we get a response back from Firebase, that means that our post notification is working. Okay, and then of course we can go ahead and do the thing in our app, but this is a way to verify that your simple procedure is working and your setup is correct and your basic code is correct. Anyway, now we'll open up Firebase and open a new tab, and over here we need to create a post method. Okay, now the post method would be this one. So this is Google's Firebase post method endpoint over here, this one. Okay, so we'll put it over here. Okay, now here for headers we need to use a key that's called authorization, this one. Okay, now this authorization key is the key of your server key. Okay, so this one. So for my project name was this one. For this project, the server key is this one, so I'll put it right here. Okay, and we also need to send content type. Okay, content type, this one. Okay, now that should be simply application JSON. Okay, now this is the headers. Remember, this shouldn't be in params or somewhere else. Okay, so this should be headers, not even authorization. It goes to headers. Now we need to work on the bodies. Now body will send raw JSON. Okay, now for this one, I've already worked on the body type, so I'll copy this one. Okay, now after that, I'll come over here and paste this. So this is the section that we want to change, because this is the earlier code and we can delete that. Okay, now here I'm trying to send ID. Now this ID is the ID of our device. Okay, and this is our notification information. This is the information that we want to send back. Okay, now this ID is the device ID, and this ID is also called client ID. Okay, and so this is the device token or ID that we are trying to send. Okay, so we'll copy this one. So we'll put it here. Okay, so as a header, we are sending server keys. So the server would know that the server would use this one for verifying that it's a valid key that has been generated. And this is the device key which Firebase will take care or keep in record. Okay, so there is a certain key for certain device, and this device key should be also unique. Okay, all right, so now with this we are ready. So if we send information and if things are good, we'll get a response back here. So this is a post notification, post method. Okay, so we'll send it. We'll click send button and we'll see what happens. Okay, so here it says that the request was missing an authentication key, please refer. So looks like we messed up somewhere. Now let's come over here, headers. Okay, so here I need to put a word that's called key. Okay, so I forgot that one, key equal, we need that one. Okay, because Firebase has to know this is a key. Okay, so this is the key and this is the value, but for the value itself you need to put here key. Okay, now here I'll send it one more time. Okay, and perfect, it worked. How do you know that it worked? Because here you see it says success 1, failure 0. Okay, so which means it worked. So which means that we were successfully able to send a notification from our device to Firebase. Okay, and Firebase gave us response as it worked. Okay, so now if this works, definitely you can go ahead and send a notification really from your device to Firebase, and which is what we'll see in other videos in the future. Anyway, so if you liked it, don't forget to subscribe and smash that like button. Thank you.